Good morning everyone, myself Sandeep Sapkar, and today we are go with class 9, subject obviously science and chapter number 1, matter in our surroundings. So today we are discussing about matter and related to the surrounding environment. So first question is, what is matter? So in nature, the large substances are there and large varieties of things which have different sizes and shapes also. So you can observe that this is a pen and this is a duster and this is a token of that pen. All three have different sizes. This is small, this is middle, and this is very bigger in size. So all the different sizes and shapes and colors of that things are made. So everything are made up from a material. So what is a material? In short, material is called as matter. So air, water, food, stone, cloud, plants, all other things are called as a matter. It is made up from materials. So what is the definition of matter? So we are broadly seeing the definition of matter. All these things occupy space, means they contain mass and volume. This is called as a matter. In short, matter have mass and volume, and it contain spaces and occupy some spaces. So this is called as a matter. So Indian philosophers have discussion on the matter, and they classified the matter into the 5 elements, commonly called as panchatattvas. So the 5 things or 5 panchatattvas are air, earth, fire, sky, and water. These 5 things are panchatattvas, and all the matters are made up from these 5 things, that is air, earth, fire, sky, and water. So living things and non-living things are made up from these 5 elements, panchatattvas. So now we learn on that concept also. So there are, in modern days, scientists classified matter into 2 types. First one is according to their physical properties, and second one is the chemical properties. So in this chapter, we are focusing on the one topic, that is according to the physical properties. Chemical properties are going to the into the next topics or next unit actually. So physical nature of matter is our next topic. Physical nature of matter. Physical nature of matter, that is how it made or what is its shape, size, and all the things. So matter is made up from a particles. The 2 thoughts competing between each other, that is the decision told like matter is made up from a wooden block or like a wooden block, and certain another things it like the it is like a sand, that is the fine particles of there uniting together and made up one thing. So all the 2 discussions are competing between them. So what is the correct one? So now we are going to see some activities, and with the help of that activities we are concluding what type of matter and what is all the requirements. So there are 3/4 activities in their books. So only one we are explaining here, and out of 4 we were explaining one here, and others are explaining into the chemistry lab, because lab is necessary to doing the activities. So try to understand this one. So activity 1, we have 100 ml beaker, and to that 100 ml beaker we have to add some salt. If salt is not there, then you have to add sugar. Stir well with the glass rod. What change is happened during that? So we make a solution of all this. So what change occur and how and the salt and sugar disappear or they may acquire into that. So all those things are coming when we perform that activities. Suppose that this is a 100 ml beaker in my hand and I put some salt into that and stir with the help of glass rod. So what change might acquire? So the salt acquire spaces and into that water and make a solution of that. In short, we called it sugar or salt. It is a solute and 100 ml beaker contain water, it is a solvent. When solute and solvent mix together to form a solution. So in short, we try to explain how to make a solution or how the matter, that is a salt and sugar, acquire spaces into the liquid, and our topic is related to that. Later we are going to see into the laboratories. So thank you.